update from Sonipat, and which you have received as a one of the portion of that. So I will try to cover that. So Sonipat is a 27 years old organization. I think one of the oldest organization in the cyber security. So from last 27 years, we are supporting all the cyber security solutions. Some of the information, like we are working with the channel partners of around 18,000 plus, 1 million plus network we protected till date. We are present in 215 countries, so wherever we are doing business. 500,000 plus organization we are working. We have almost 290 plus patents and 3 million plus firewalls shipped till date. This is the threat report. So what we do is every year we publish our threat report. So based on our observation, because this is an ongoing process, every day, 365 days, 24 by 7, we are accumulating data. And based on that, we publish a report. The purpose of this report is so that our customers can take a judgmental call that what is the pattern, and based on that, they can invest in cybersecurity. So that's the process. So what we do is, once in a year we publish the full report, then in the mid of the year we publish media report, and then every quarter we publish that whatever the changes is happening. So recently we have published the media report. So how we work? So this is the backbone. So we have a capture threat network, and these are works on 1 million plus sensors. So we have sensors across country, across world. And those sensors are actually, whatever the attacks is happening, it's getting captured and sending it to our capture threat network, which is working on 365 days, 24/7. And if you see that we are, these are some of the data that we are getting: 140,000 malware samples per day, 28 million malware attacks blocked per day. So these are some of the data. So this is a dedicated team which is actually working for that to get those data. And we analyze 10.5 billion malware attacks in 2018. So see, these are some of the data. Extensive malware library. So from last 27 years, we are collecting all these data, right? All these malware. So it's a more of a terabytes of data. And based on that, we are working and we are giving the solutions to our customer. So these are some of the facts. In 2019, if you see, in 2018 first half, which is from January till June, similarly 2019 first half, so this is based on the recent report, we have seen that there is a malware attack is decreasing. So there is a 4.78 billion malware attack the first half, which is 20% year to date decrease. So there is a decrease in the malware. But then malware is decreasing, but then there is a specific type of attacks are increasing, right? So generic malware is decreased, but then if you see the malware attacks, okay, 20% decrease, which I have just spoken about, but then intrusion attack is 4% increase, web application attack, 11% increase, ransomware attack, which is 15% increase, IoT attacks, which is 55%, and encrypted attack, which is 76% increase. But these are some of the, now the conclusion is it's more of an, instead of generic attack, it's more of a specific type of attacks are happening. We can share you this information, you don't have to write. Right, Jadish, we have the soft copy, right? I can share you that. Or you can download from our website. Okay, so what we are talking about is, okay, now we are also enhancing our technology. Similarly, the cyber criminals are also enhancing their technology. So this is a fight between good and bad, and it's going on. So what we are talking about, like the overall malware is down, which is a good news because of our maybe overall cyber security technology. I'm not talking about Sonipat. Memory threats identified early. So we have started identifying memory level threats. We will talk about that. Machine learning is one of the new technology or the advancement which we are doing across industry. Everyone is using this technology. Malicious PDF and office files, briefly deep. There is a deep, we will talk about that. And global phishing trending down. So phishing attacks are now we have seen is slightly down recently. What happened is the ransomware RAS rising. This is an interesting thing which we have noticed, which is called ransomware as services. So you must have heard the security as a services, software as a services. So this is a new trend which is happening, ransomware as a services. So the people are using as a proper business of ransomware so that they can earn money through the ransomware. Encrypted attack is intensifying. So now if you have noticed that today all our network is encrypted. So if you check any of the website, now every website is HTTPS. You will never see any website of HTTP. So S means it's actually encrypted. So when we are talking about network as encrypted, the attacks are also coming up in an encrypted form. IoT attack is escalating. Non-standard port is another concern. Bitcoin value keeping crypto jacking in place. So this is another new kind of things are happening. So let me know if you have any question here, you can stop me, I can talk in detail, or else maybe you can ask me later. So these are some of the observation. So these are 2018, which we have seen, like 25,000 malware attacks, which is 22% over 2017. But between January and June 2019, we have seen a decrease in the malware. 490 ransomware attack, which is 11% increase, which we have seen last year. We have seen 263 ransomware attack, which is 15% more in this year. Within the half year. 19% malware using non-standard port, now it is 13% malware non-standard port, which is, you may say now it's only 13% versus 19%, but this is within half year 13%, so it is actually more. So similarly, some of the attacks are decreasing, some of the attacks are increasing, like phishing attacks, there is a decrease, which is 9%. Okay, so this is interesting. 194,000 new attack variants, which is 1073 per day, detected by our capture ATP, which is 45% increase. So this is the new variants. So it is not that, the older variant. So what is happening is every day there is a new type of attacks are getting generated. And what we have seen, our capture ATP is a tool which is advanced threat protection, where we are analyzing the unknown attack every day. And that's alarmingly high, which is 45% growth. So we have just covered 2-3 slides, maybe I can repeat that. Okay, so the malware volume, top global countries. So what we have seen is that the malware volume overall, the malware has decreased. So overall, globally, there is a decrease. But if you see in India, there is an increase. Switzerland, there is an increase. Netherlands, there is. So this is a little tricky thing, which is going to keep on happening. Whether sometime there is a decrease in India, maybe globally it is increased. Sometime the decrease or increase, decrease in India, global increase, or reverse, vice versa. This is a ransomware volume, YTD. So UK, in first half, we have seen 2.2 million, which is 195% change. Global, which is 15% change. So more of ransomware attacks are happening in UK. It is actually contrary to our 6 month older report. If you see UK, there was a decrease. Now there is all of a sudden increase. So if you see the trend, the 6 months back, there was a decrease in the ransomware in UK and India. All of a sudden, they have increased. So that is more of a trend which we can see is they are trying to create an environment that so that user feel that now we are safe. So in the December, when we have published our last year data, there was a 15% decrease in ransomware in UK. Now in UK has increased 195%. So that is the way they are actually playing with us. Okay, so India is still, there is a decrease, which is a minus 62%. So that means we can expect that there will be some bigger attack may come in the near future. Okay, so this is the basically the non-standard port, which is another thing which is happening these days. So it's more of a technical thing. If you have interest, maybe you can discuss that, or else maybe we can skip. What happened is, in the summary, when we configure any solution, so there is a particular port we define, that this port is for this particular network or particular traffic. Normally, majority of the vendors, they don't scan each and every port. And those guys or our cyber criminals are actually utilizing that technology that, okay, now they have understood that majority of the vendors are not scanning each and every port, but the non-standard port they are using to send the malware. So which is increasing, and anyway, this is one of the strengths which we have. We are scanning each and every packet and every port. But this is a new trend which is happening. This is an encrypted malware attack which I was talking about. Now today our 70% of our networks are encrypted, and which we have seen recently, encrypted attacks are more than 78% attacks are coming through the encrypted channel. 76%, sorry, 2.4 million encrypted attacks. SonicWall Capture ATP Sandbox. So this is one of the patent pending technology called real-time deep memory inspection. So what we do is, when we analyze all unknown attacks through different technologies, which we came up in 6 quarter back, the new technology called real-time deep memory inspection, we are analyzing even the memory level attacks, which we have seen there is a huge growth in the memory level attack. And you can see it's around 34. So on that RTDM, I identified 74,360 never before seen malware variants, which is 35.3% increase. PDF and office threats. Recently, we have seen there is a degrowth. I'm sure, I don't know whether you have seen. Do you think that PDF or office files are safe today? Have you ever thought of on this? Majority of our customers don't believe, or they don't they consider that if PDF is coming, it is safe. Today, this is one of the medium, like cyber criminals are embedding the malware on PDF. So when you are downloading a PDF, you are actually, there is a probability that the malware can come through PDF. So this is a different type of attack, because normally all our customers, or as a normal human being, we understand that PDF is safe, right? So this is, which we have seen till December, there was an increase, but recently we have seen drop. But this drop is actually giving us alert that something may come up again, and maybe in a bigger way. So what exactly the SonicWall story? So what SonicWall does, so of course we analyze all these threats, what is happening throughout the world based on all those attacks. This is our vision, that automated real-time breach detection and prevention. When there is a multiple different kind of attacks, and if you have seen the volume of attack, which is in millions and billions, it is not possible for any organization to do and analyze manually. So we have created a automated process. Through that, we analyze all those attacks, and we try to solve that. So what? These are the three components. So like, these are the threats. When we are talking about ransomware, fileless malware, encrypted malware, and the challenges are that we cannot define that, okay, it is coming only through the network. It can come through any means, right? It can be from wireless, it can be from your tablet, your phone, your IoT device. So that's what we are discussing. And today, you cannot define that, okay, when you are in the network, that means you are unsafe, right? Maybe through something can come through the network, through internet. Even You can be attacked, or someone can attack through your phone. Your phone can be hijacked, or you can actually start seeing or start recording whatever you are talking. If someone is using the smart TVs can be controlled remotely and can be seen that what exactly is happening at your room. Right? You are using Alexas. So many things can happen. We are talking about smart cities. Now smart cities using smart meters. Recently there was in one of the countries there was an attack that all smart meters has been collapsed by some country and then entire countries stop, electricity supply stop. So these are kind of, you know, many type of attacks are happening, and then we have solutions like, you know, machine learning, we have solutions, the blocks, filing, team wording. So various ways we try and we are achieving this objective. So these are some of the solutions which we have, like we have firewall, we have wireless security, we have mobile endpoint, email security, cloud access, we have IoTs, and all these things, you know, can be monitored, managed from a single pane of glass. So that's our solution. So that, because what we have heard from our customers is it's very difficult, because now 250 type of security solutions available in market, which one I should buy, right? So what we came out with, okay, fine, there is a solution. I will talk about that, how we are protecting that, which is called the layered security. But everything can be managed from a single pane of glass. You don't have to manage your email security separately, firewall separately, wireless separately. So this is our solution in a nutshell. This is looks very technical, but simply I'll just give you a quick thing how it works. All this file, it can, you know, file can come from all this way, either it's through email or your network. Then what we do is we stream data, we check the data when it is coming through any of our devices, it's a firewall or email security. It goes to our deep algorithm, which is a machine learning, and it if it understands it is known attack, so then there is a signature is already there, right? Majority of the organization work on known attacks. If it is a signature, we block. If it is, there is no signature, if it is unknown, it goes to another engine, which is called Cloud Capture Sandbox. There is a multi-level engine, which is again a unique USP for us, where we have recently added deep memory inspection, where we do multiple type of scanning till the memory level. And if we see that, okay, it's safe, then it's sent to the user. If it is not safe, it goes to again the deep algorithm, where we create signature and then protect all other users. Hope this is clear with simple.